Hello everyone, today we'll discuss part 32 of the NEET PG important questions, and today we'll discuss about the questions of the topic hand. So first try to answer the question by yourself first. What kind of skin is present in the palm? It is glabrous. It is devoid of sebaceous gland. There is presence of the sweat glands, and the skin over here is immobile. Types of creases or the lines on the palmar skin are flexure lines, papillary ridges, and the cleavage lines. What are Langer lines of the cleavage? They are produced by the collagen fibers in the dermis. They are transverse on the dorsum of the fingers, and they are longitudinal on the palmar surface of the fingers. What do papillary ridges from the dermal papilla form? They form the fingerprint pattern on the distal phalanges. They also form different patterns like loop, rolls, composite. They are different for each individual. So papillary ridges from the dermal papilla are different for each individual. What is the study of the fingerprints called? It is called as the dermatoglyphics. Origin and the insertion of the palmaris brevis muscle. It originates from the palmar aponeurosis, flexure denaculum, and inserts in the skin of the palm or the dermis in the ulnar side. It is subcutaneous striated muscle and is present in the superficial fascia, and it is the remnant of the panicular stenosis. So palmaris brevis is the remnant of the panicular stenosis. What is the nerve supply and the action of the palmaris brevis muscle? So it is supplied by the superficial branch of the ulnar nerve, and it improves the grip by steadying the skin of the palm. Flexure denaculum, palmar aponeurosis, and the fibrous flexured digital sheet are modification of what? The modification of the deep fascia of the palm. Flexure denaculum is attached medially to the hook of Hammett and pisiform, while the flexure denaculum is attached laterally to the tubercle of the scaphoid and the trapezium bone. Groove of trapezium lodges what? It lodges flexure carpi radialis muscle. Flexure denaculum blends proximally and distally with what? So it blends proximally with the antebrachial fascia or the deep fascia of the forearm or the fascia covering the flexure digitorum superficialis. This is the same thing. Distally with the palmar aponeurosis. Flexure denaculum gives origin to which muscles of hand? It gives origin to the thenar muscles and the hypothenar muscles. Which structures passes superficial to the flexure denaculum? So palmaris longus tendon, palmar cutaneous branch of the median nerve, and the palmar cutaneous branch of the ulnar nerve passes superficial to the flexure denaculum. Which structures passes deep to the flexure denaculum? So median nerve, tendon of flexure digitorum superficialis, tendon of the flexure digitorum profundus, tendon of the flexure process longus, and the tendon of the flexure carpi radialis are the structures passing deep the flexure denaculum. Describe the radial bursa. Radial bursa forms the synovial sheet of the flexure process longus, and it is continuous with the digital synovial sheet of the thumb. It passes deep the flexure denaculum. Describe the ulnar bursa. Ulnar bursa is also the synovial tendon sheet, and it contains or sheets four tendon of the FDS and the FDP, that means the flexure digitorum superficialis and the flexure digitorum profundus. It is continuous with the digital synovial sheet of the little finger, and it passes deep to the flexure retinaculum. Carpal tunnel syndrome is caused by compression of the median nerve beneath the flexure retinaculum. What are the common causes of the carpal tunnel syndrome? So it can be pregnancy, hyperthyroidism, or accustomed use of the wrist joint. Which carpal bone is commonly associated with the carpal tunnel syndrome? So the lunate bone. What is palmar aponeurosis? Palmar aponeurosis is the modification of the deep fascia, and it is a degenerated insertion of the palmaris longus. Its central part is thick, and median and the lateral part cover the hypothenar and the thenar muscles. It is triangular in outline with apex at the proximal where it blends with the flexure denaculum. Medial palmar septum is attached to which bone? It is attached to the shaft of the fifth metacarpal bone. Lateral palmar septum is attached to which bone? To the shaft of the first metacarpal bone. Describe the Dupuytren's contracture. Dupuytren's contracture is the inflammatory contracture of the palmar aponeurosis. Over here, the ring finger is mostly commonly involved. Fibrous flexure sheet of the digits extends from the metacarpal head to the base of the distal phalanx. It crosses the metacarpophalangeal joint, proximal and the distal phalangeal joints also. It has thick zones over the phalanx and thin zones over the joints. Fibrous flexure sheets contains what? So it contains single tendon for the thumb, that is the flexure pollicis longus in the thumb, and two for other fingers, that is the flexure digitorum superficialis and the flexure digitorum profundus for the fingers. Okay, so single tendon for the thumb, that is the FPL, and two for other fingers, that is FDS and the FDP for fingers. Each finger is present with how many vincula brevia and the vincula longa? So each finger is present with 2 vincula brevia and 3 vincula longa. Name the thenar muscles. So there are 3 thenar muscles, that is the abductor pollicis brevis, opponens pollicis and the flexure pollicis brevis. Which is the most lateral thenar muscle? It is the abductor pollicis brevis. Flexure pollicis brevis is supplied by which nerve? By the recurrent branch of the median nerve and also ulnar nerve. Adductor pollicis is supplied by which nerve? Adductor pollicis is supplied by the ulnar nerve. Name the hypothenar muscle. So they are 3. Flexure digiti minimi, opponens digiti minimi and the abductor digiti minimi. Hypothenar muscles are supplied by which nerve? By the deep branch of the ulnar nerve. What is the origin and the insertion of the lumbricals? So lumbricals are basically 4 in number and they originates from the tendon of the flexure digitorum profundus and they inserts at the dorsal digital expansion. Which lumbrical have the dual nerve supply? So third lumbrical have dual nerve supply, that is median and the ulnar nerve. Median and the ulnar nerve. Nerve supply the lumbricals. So the first and the second lumbrical is supplied by the median nerve and the first and the second lumbricals are unipinnate. While third and the fourth are supplied by the ulnar nerve and they are, third and fourth are bipinnate. What is the shape of the lumbricals appears like? They appear like earthworms. How many palmar and the dorsal interossei are there? So there are 4 palmar and the 4 dorsal interossei. Okay. And the palmar interossei is unipinnate while the dorsal interossei are bipinnate. What is the action of the palmar interossei? Palmar interossei actually adducts the finger. So they are the adductor of the finger. They also cause the flexion at the metacarpophalangeal joint and the extension at the interphalangeal joint. What is the action of the dorsal interossei? They abducts the finger. So they are the abductors at the finger. They also cause the flexion at the metacarpophalangeal joint and extension at the interphalangeal joint. Which structure passes through the 2 heads of the first dorsal interossei? Radial artery. What is the nerve supply of the interossei? Ulnar nerve. Ulnar artery with which nerve passes superficial to the flexure denaculum? So ulnar artery with the ulnar nerve passes superficial to the flexure denaculum. Which branch of ulnar artery is the direct continuation of it? Superficial branch of the ulnar artery is a direct continuation of it. Ulnar artery is main contribution to which palmar arch? To the superficial palmar arch. Superficial palmar arch is formed by which arteries? By the ulnar artery, superficial palmar branch of the radial artery, arteria princeps pollicis and the arteria radialis indicis. Deep palmar arch is formed by which artery? By the deep branch of the ulnar artery and terminal branch or terminal part of the radial artery. Deep breath of ulnar nerve pierces what? It pierces opponent's digiti minimi. So today up till here, we'll discuss about the further important notes and questions of further important topic in our next video. Thank you so much.